Welcome to ExcelBerry. In this video, you'll learn about Power Query, which is the ultimate tool for connecting, transforming, and optimizing your data. I worked 3 years at KPMG as an audit associate, and I never learned Power Query, and I'm a bit annoyed that they didn't teach us that. What you can do with Power Query, for example, is that you can extract data from a PDF file instead of trying to copy it and paste it into Excel and it doesn't fit into different columns. You can easily do this with Power Query. Or let's say that you extract a file from another system that gives you an Excel file, and to this Excel file you do multiple different transformations each month. Then you can, in Power Query, do the transformation and just change the Excel files. You don't have to repeat all the transformations that you do. Or one of my best example is that, let's say you're in a budget period and you have 20 different divisions and each of them gives you an Excel file that you want to combine into one Excel file, and that's so easily done in Power Query. In this video, you will learn what it is and how you use it. So what is Power Query? So it's a data connectivity and data transformation tool that can be used to retrieve data from a wide variety of sources, such as a database, text file, and web service. I will show you all the sources soon. Then you can easily manipulate and transform the data in a numerous ways. So that is the description of what Power Query is. And why you should use it is that it saves time and efforts by automating many of the tedious and repetitive tasks involved in working with data. So you do it one time and not each month, each week, each time you extract data from a source. And also, if you have a large amount of data, you can have more rows in Power Query than you can have in Excel. And it also makes the file smaller. And like I said before, you can combine multiple Excel files into one very easily. Also, it includes smart AI-based data transformation. I will show you what this means later, but this is extremely powerful as well. So how do you use Power Query? It's usually three steps. First, you connect to your data, then you transform it, and then you close and load it into Excel. And there you can save it and share it. So the first step, connect your data. You find Power Query in the data ribbon here under Get and Transform Data. So in this section, you'll find all you need for Power Query. And once you have a connection, you can go here to the Queries and Connection and press on Queries and Connection. And you'll find here to the right all the different queries and connection that you have in this Excel file. Let's go back here to Get and Transform Data. So under Get Data, we have all the different sources that you can connect to. Here in From File, we have, for example, an Excel file, text file, PDF, or this From folder. So if you have multiple different Excel files in a specific folder, you can connect to all of them if they look the same. And this is something that we will try out soon. Then you have From Database, here you have SQL and Microsoft Access, we have Azure, we have Power BI, and here we have From Web. So if you find information on a web page, and this does not always work because sometimes it looks like a picture and then Power Query can't understand what it means. You can try to connect to a web page and get your information directly into Excel. And if the web page changes, or if the Excel file changes, or if the PDF file changes, you just update the query and all the transformation and all the connections will be updated and the data will be updated in your Excel file. That's also one great thing about Power Query. Let's say you have a PDF file, then you can just replace it and then update the query and you will update the data in the Excel file. That's the first step, connect. Then you have transform. So you transform your data into how you want it to look like. You make all these changes that you want. You can pretty much do everything that you can do in Excel. And once you're finished, you press on close and load in the top left corner, and it will be extracted into Excel. And if you want to find it again, you can go here to the right section, Queries and Connection, and double click on it, and you will open up Power Query again, or you go to Get Data and press on Launch Power Query Editor. We go to Get Data from File, from PDF, and here we have a PDF file that's the earnings for quarter two for Twitter. If we just open this one up here, we will get to the Navigator. Here we have the entire PDF file, and the Power Query will find different tables. So you can press on a table. Is this the data that you want to get into Excel? So maybe, maybe not. And here in the bottom, you have the pages instead. So it's all the data that's in one page. So in page 7, in that PDF file, we have the balance sheet. If we press on transform data, we will open up the Power Query editor. Now we have the balance sheet for Twitter. And if we just go to the home ribbon and press on close and load, this data, like it looks now, will be transformed into Excel. If we want to, we can make different transformation. In this case, we just go and press on close and load because that's how we wanted to do it. Then we can change it in Excel here instead. Just erase these and this one. So this is pretty much how I want it to look like. And here we have the balance sheet into Excel quite quickly. In the next case, we want to connect to multiple Excel files. So we go to the data ribbon, get data from file, from folder. And what you need to think about is that the files need to be exactly the same. The sheet names need to be the same, and how they look needs to be the same. So here we have the files with multiple files. In this one, we have three different Excel files. We have one called blueberries, raspberry, and strawberry. Instead of pressing on transform data, we press on combine and transform data. So this one is a new box that appears, and this is which one do you want to be a sample file? So you make all the transformations to a sample file, which will happen to all the files in that folder. So yeah, I want to have the first file as my sample file, and I want this sheet, berry, to be what I want to connect to. And then I press on OK. It will open up Power Query, and now you can see that it has data from all my three different Excel files. So here's the source name. Here, for example, let's say that the total was missing, so we remove this one, and we want to add a total, that's the quantity times the price. We can do this in Power Query by pressing on Add Column, and then we have column from example, so you write an example, and then it will try to understand what you want to do. Or we can add a custom column. In this case, we want to add a custom column. That's basically a formula. We want to have the quantity multiplied with the price, and then press on OK. So here we have made a custom column that's the total quantity times price. What's good to know is that it doesn't work exactly like Excel. So this is another language. If we go to the home ribbon and advanced editor, here you will find all the steps that you do. And this language is called M, and it's not exactly like how it works in Excel. So the formulas will not be exactly the same. If you want to use the mid, left, right function, that will not work the same way here in the Power Query editor. So then you probably need to Google it before or use the ChatGPT. So let's erase this. And another good thing to know is here to the right, we have our all applied steps. So here we first connect to the source, we filter hidden files, we invoke a custom function, we rename the columns, remove other columns, expand table columns, change the type, remove columns, and then add a custom one. So if you want to go back and add a step in between a step, that's possible. Or if it doesn't work, you can go step by step backwards until you find what's wrong with all these steps. So somewhere something is wrong. And perhaps you're finished now. You press on close and load, and your data from all the three files will be in Excel now. And that is great when you work with multiple files to get all the data into one Excel file. And that is pretty much all I wanted to show you in this video. Like if you learned something new, subscribe if you want to learn even more in Excel, and go my course on ExcelBerry.com. Thank you.